Google Drive is a cloud storage service that allows you to store and access your files from anywhere. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create, upload, share, and organize your files using Google Drive, both online and on the Google Drive for desktop app. Whether you need to work on a document, spreadsheet, presentation, or any other type of file, Google Drive can help you get it done in no time. So without taking much of our time, let's get started.
To access Gmail, you have two methods. Okay, the first one is you can come to the Google Apps over here, just click on it, and you'll be able to see Drive over here. So you can see you can move it up also for ease of access. And once you click, it's going to land you on a fresh Google Drive like this one. Okay, so this is Google Drive. And over here, you will be able to drag and drop your files and sync them, whether they're media or audio, video, you can drag and drop them here. So everything is housed on my drive. Usually you are given 15 gigabyte of size for free to use. This is the first method to access. The second method is you can still come to your search bar and just search for drive.google.com. Okay, and once you hit on enter, it's going to bring you over to this very platform as well. So it's the two ways that you can access. And from this drive, you'll be able to access different other applications as well. For example, when you come to this new, you'll be able to have access to Google Docs, okay, Google Sheets and Google Slides, Google Forms, and you can see many more over here. You can connect Google Drawings, Google Maps, Sites, and so on. And you can add other applications as well to have access to them directly. So once you click on any of these, it's going to directly take you to Google Slides or Google Docs, as the case may be. Today we are not after this. For this class, we are not after Google Docs. It's just to show you another feature added within the Google Drive. So you have access to My Computer. From the computer you're on, you'll be able to work with it on the computer. If you are shared an item or if anything is shared with you, you'll be able to see it here. Okay, you can check out recent, any document that you've worked on or you've uploaded, you'll see it on recent. Okay, start items. If you start any item, you'll be able to see it over here. Spam as well. Same like inbox, you'll be able to see the bin. When you delete an item, you'll be able to see over here. And down here, you'll be able to see the storage status. How close are you to exhausting the free storage? Okay, so you'll be able to see from here. And then at any time, you can delete the content from the bin and then you have more storage. Or they're about. Now you can bring in your files over here. You can search just like in the other apps or in the other Gmail, you can search directly any document that you have saved here. And you can create file. So you can create a file, you can upload a file or a folder. So for example, you can say new folder and you can make it my document. And you'll have this as a folder within your Google Drive. Okay, under my drive. If you want, you can create multiple. Can just click and then you can have my masters. All your document related to masters can be saved over here. So you can click to open them. And then once you open a particular folder, you can drag and drop different kind of media, different kind of files. So this is the first way. You can drag and drop. For example, you can come over here. You can select any file. For example, these two. I can select these two, drag them and drop them here and they will just be uploaded in my drive and they'll be stored here. So you can see they are being uploaded from here. Okay, so you'll be able to monitor the progress. This one has just been uploaded and you can see the both of them have been uploaded. You can be able to see who is the owner. It's me. And then what is the last stage they have been modified. You can see the sizing of the file. You can see and other features as well. You may be able to add other people, collaborate with other people on this same file. So all you need is just to click over here and you'll be able to add the email address of those people. So for example, I want to collaborate with this guy. I can write him a message directly and say, this is the file. Okay, and he will take notes and you can see the actions over here. It can be a viewer, a commenter, or an editor. You can set all that before sending to him. Or you can edit as well. Anybody with this link or who is added here can edit or can do anything accordingly. Then here you'll be able to see the details, the properties of that particular file, where it is and what are some of the key features. And then the activities that were done on that file, you'll be able to see it over here. You'll be able to see the history of the activities done. Yeah, you can always close on this. You can see this file had been shared with this guy. Okay, it's been uploaded. This is when it is uploaded and it is, you created the shared item on this. All right. So this is it. This is the first method to drag and drop items, or you can upload directly. Maybe coming back to my drive, you can upload directly. You can upload a file, okay? Or you can upload a complete folder. For example, let's say I want to upload a file. I want to upload this simple image. And you can see I've just uploaded it and it is going to stay here. You can see it, it has been uploaded. From here, you can click and you'll be able to see preview of that particular image. And then you can be able to open it with different applications, or you can download it from here. We can download if you want it on your desktop. You can click to download. And you can see it's just been downloaded. And then over here, you'll be able to add it to, you add comments to it. You can add a comment to this particular document, or you can come to these three dots and do many other things. For example, you can share, you can move, you can add it to stand, or you can rename it, or you can check out the details, or you want to open it in a different tab. You can do all that from here. So this is about file import. You can upload a file and you can upload a complete folder. Okay, so let's upload a complete folder and then let's see how it is being done. So for example, in my desktop, I have small folder. For example, this one that I call PayFile is just a folder. I can click and it's going to upload it directly. So you can see it's been uploaded and you'll be able to see the progress down here. It has been uploaded and it has been uploaded. Okay, so this is about uploading files. You can change the view from here. This is the normal list view. You can change it to grid view or list layout. I think I prefer it like this for ease of access, what they are about. And from here as well, you can be able to have access to all of these features. You'll be able to have access to most of the other Google apps, and you can add some. So within the Google Drive, you'll be able to have access to other applications and work on them directly. So this is Drive. This is my document. This is what is inside my documents. If you want to share it with someone, for example, I want to share this complete folder in my document. Alternatively, you can select and you can right click on it. On the right clicking, you can see you can open it with these apps and you can download, you can rename, you can share, can organize. Okay, sharing means you can copy the link or you can check out the share item. You can organize them in folders in different colors. You can give the folders coloration for ease of access and ease of recognition. You can see you can give a color. Maybe I can say green color to this so that I can know by green color, I mean this folder, and by red color, I mean this folder. It's ease of access. Then you can check out the file information, details, activities, and search within PayPal. You can search, conduct search within that particular folder. And then you can move it to bin. Once you click on move to bin, it's going to go directly to the bin. Like I've explained, anything deleted, you can come to the bin and you see it over here. You'll have the option also to restore it or delete it forever once you click on delete forever. And then we're back to my drive and we're back over here. So you want to share this document. This is my document. You can right click on it, come to share over here, and then you'll be able to write the email address of the person. But then before you write the email, you'll see the people who have access to this. It's this guy. And then if you want to set in the control, you can come down here and say restricted. Anyone with this link, now you can give the control. He can be a viewer, he can be a commenter, or he can be an editor like I've explained earlier. You can set the control from here directly, and then you can write his email if you want. Okay, so let's say I want to collaborate with this guy, so we can write some email, or you can just go ahead and copy the link. You can see now the link had been copied. And once you paste this, once you send this to him and he passes the email, it's going to give him access to that particular folder directly. Okay. So this is the beauty of Google Drive. It's very, very nice. You can send him and he's going to receive this as an email. So assuming I want to collaborate with my friend with Epic Mentorship. So I can just say Epic Mentorship 1, use this email. All right. And I can write this message. Find the file here, and when I send this and you log into your Gmail, okay, so if I log into my Gmail, I'll be able to have access to this, and you see it as an email sent to me. So once I click, I'll be able to have access to it directly.
So to start with, let me show you the two ways to get to Google Drive for desktop. If you have your drive opened, for example, right now I have my drive opened, you will be able to see it down here at the bottom. If you at the bottom left, if you have not installed it already, you will see the link to have the desktop version. But if you have installed it, then you will have to download it somewhere else. So the second method is you can come to Google
All right, you can just come to Google and then you can search for Google Drive for desktop, just like so. You can see it over here. And you can go for the first option, which is Google Drive under Google. You can see it. So you can just say Drive, Google Drive. Okay, so what you should pay attention to here is this one, download for desktop. Okay, download Drive for desktop. And it's available for iOS as well and Android. You can find this even on your mobile device, so you can download and use it as you so wish. So you can just go ahead and click on this. Whether you're operating on Windows or Mac operating system, it's going to give you the needed version. Okay, it's automatically going to detect and it's going to give you the version you need. So once you launch it, you can open it from your Google Drive, from your launchpad over here. So you can see, once you launch it, or alternatively, you will still be able to see it at the top here, at the top of this status bar. So you can see it here, Drive. Once you click, you'll be able to monitor all the activities that you've done on the Drive. Okay, all the files that you've synchronized. If you've synchronized a file, you see it ticked. And if it's not synchronized, you will see it with some sign, which maybe I'll show you later. And then this is telling you the status of all of these files. Everything is up to date, which means they've all been uploaded to the cloud. Okay, so if you have any notification, you'll be able to see it over here. And at this moment, I don't have any. You can search directly within the Google Drive. You can search for files. You can search for any documents that you want to use. And then still from here, you can come to this gear icon, which is one of the most important things you should pay attention to. Once you hit on the gear icon, you can set up preferences. These are the two things you would like to. There are two things here very important to understand when it comes to Google Drive for desktop. The first one is you see your computer. This is MacBook Pro, and you can add any folder within the MacBook that you want the Google Drive to synchronize. So over here, you can just select any folder. And you can just navigate to wherever you have that folder, and you can just name it. You can just select that folder, and once you click on open, it's going to ask you these two questions. Okay, the first one is you want to synchronize with Google Drive, or you want to back up the content of this folder in Google Photos, which usually is photos and videos. I would like to keep it up in the Google Drive. I just want to synchronize it on Google Drive. But if you want to go with the Google Photos as well, you can select to synchronize the videos and photos over there. You can say OK to this. And this is now going to be added to the list of folders that I have within my system that have been synchronized to Google Drive. So everything inside this folder will be synchronized to the cloud. And so this is the first one. You can select any folder within the system and synchronize it to and connect it with Google Drive, which means all of its content will be synchronized to your Google Drive. So you can as well go to the second option, which is in this case I forgot to save, so you can save, so which means everything here is going to be synchronized. The second one is the Google Drive. So the Google Drive, you will usually find it at any of your file explorer. You can see it over here, Google Drive. So whatever is in your drive, whatever is in my drive, is being synchronized over here. So as you click to open, you will see all the data that I have within my drive. And all of it, when you see this cloud sign, it just simply means that they are already in on the cloud, but they are not on the system. Okay, they are on the cloud, but not on the system. I'll show you how to make them available on the system. In case if you don't want to keep them on cloud. So over here, you have access to Google Drive. So you have two very important settings. You can stream files, which means you can store all my drive files in the cloud only, and I don't want to keep them on my system. So by that, you will have more space, except for files that you've attempted to open or you try to make offline, then it will be stored on your drive, on your system. And you can mirror the files, which means you can have copies of them on your system and copies of them on the cloud. This selection gives you less space on your computer because the files are going to be still around within your system. And it's good for offline access in cases when you have found yourself in a place where there is no network, you can still work accordingly. So it's very, very, so the choice is yours. You can just make the choice accordingly. So what I wanted to show you is on a given drive, for example, this one, If you want to make a file to be an offline file, you can select any file. And if you want to make it available all offline, you can just right click and come down here and say access. You can see available offline. You can just select this and it's going to be made available offline. With this green tick, it means it is available offline and you can still have it online as well. And if you want to remove it on the system and make it available online only, you can still come back, right click it and just come down and say online only, and it's going to delete a copy of that that has been saved on your system. So that's the beauty of Google Drive for desktop. It enables you to play around with the files and save your space and time, and maybe sometimes to enable you have quick access to the data. So you can still come back here to the drive at the top, and you can still come to this preferences. You can check out offline files and you'll be able to remove some cache files, and you can check the sizes of your offline files accordingly. And then you can still come back and check on still on the gear icon. You can see error list if you have any error, and then you can pause synchronization in cases when you don't want to synchronize. Maybe you don't have enough data, you can synchronize, or you can check out other things, and you can quit the Google Drive for desktop. Whenever you want to add any file to the Google Drive for desktop, you have the option to add from here. You can just drag any file, just drag and drop, and it's going to be synchronized to the drive. Or you can come to my document where we have that my backed up files. So you can see these are files I've added that are backed up on the drive. You can still add more. If you want them to be added also, you can still drag and drop. And any file that's inside here is going to be automatically synchronized to the cloud. So you can open the Google Drive and you'll be able to see these files that I've just added have been synchronized. These two that I've just added, you can see they've been synchronized and added. So we can go back to the drive on the cloud and try to check to confirm whether our files have been added. The ones that we've added within the computer, you will see them on my computer here. All the files that I have synchronized and added. Sorry, it's not this account, it's this account. So all the files that I've added under my computer, you'll be able to see them over here. So these are the two files I added. This is my MacBook Pro. This is my MacBook Pro. You can see the two files I've added. These are the two this thing that I've added. So this is what I've just added lastly just now. So it's been synchronized and it's available online as well. So it's very easy to have access. So you have access to your computer, and my drive, which is this one, the Google Drive, my drive, you can see all of its content, all of these features, all of these files are already synchronized here. So it's very easy, and it enables you to move around across between one of the platforms to another.